T-minus 2 hours and a few minutes. Don't do math on TV. Until the federal government shuts down, unless the United States Senate passes a bill to keep it funded before then. In terms of what's going to happen tonight, it's kind of anybody's guess. We are still expecting the big vote to happen just in a few minutes at the top of the hour. If you want to handicap how that vote is going to go, you're on your own. I do not bet. But people are starting to read a lot into the fact that, according to Jake Sherman of Politico.com, apparently Democrats in the House have just scheduled a work meeting for tomorrow morning, a members-only meeting tomorrow morning on the topic of, quote, Republicans' continued refusal to work with Democrats to keep the government open. So read into that what you will. But I read that as Democrats, at least Democrats in the House, not having very high expectations that the government is about to get funded tonight, thereby averting the shutdown so everybody can go home for the weekend. Not if they're planning an all meeting tomorrow to talk about why the shutdown happened. Among all the things that now hang in the balance, obviously the jobs of hundreds of thousands of people who work for the federal government who are potentially about to be furloughed. Also, crucial programs like the CDC's flu tracking program. The flu this year has already killed a lot of people. Also, the fate of the Dreamers, people who were brought here as young people who've been protected by the DACA program that the Republicans have been trying to kill. Also, there's something else you should know about. Last fall, funding for the Children's Health Insurance Program, CHIP, ran out. This is a non-controversial program. It's a health insurance program that covers 9 million kids across the country. It was originally created by Orrin Hatch and Ted Kennedy. Totally bipartisan, non-controversial, super high support in both parties. It's seen as a bipartisan success story. But the program's funding ran out last fall. And instead of reauthorizing that program right then and there, Republicans passed just a quick little fix to fund it for a few months longer. Well, that quick little fix is about to run out again tonight, unless Congress reauthorizes it, which they definitely could have already done by now. Taking on CHIP as a standalone matter would not be a controversial thing. Instead, they decided to attach it to this short-term spending bill as a way to try to coerce Democrats to get on board with everything else they're trying to do. Well, while that's happening in Washington, in the meantime, states have been scrambling to alert parents that their kids' health insurance coverage could soon be cut off if Congress doesn't extend CHIP's funding. In some cases, health insurance for kids and babies and pregnant women, insurance that these people already have, is going to be cut off as early as February. Connecticut's healthcare program, for example, is alerting parents to schedule appointments for their kids before the end of March, when the Connecticut health program is scheduled to end. I mean, there's a lot hanging in the balance right now, but watching this happen in Washington sometimes makes it feel like a game. If you're a parent right now who's got a kid who's being treated for an ongoing critical or even terminal illness, right, and you're facing potentially, you know, medical bills, not just that it'll be hard for you to pay, but that you can't pay. And because of what's happening tonight, your kids are going to lose their health insurance because Congress is playing with this. And they're playing with all the rest of it. Well, what's happening tonight isn't just ridiculous. It's disgusting. Senate is expected to hold a vote at 10 p.m. Eastern tonight on the short-term spending bill passed by House Republicans yesterday. It doesn't seem at this moment that there are enough votes to stop the bill. To pass the bill and prevent a shutdown. Things are very, very fluid right now. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to be live for the duration watching this happen. Stay with us.